spirit. So now I gotta do what I gotta die unto him. So now that I know that he is sin, it's not my dog on cigarettes. It's not my dress. Come on, talk to me here. It's the natural man, the thing that my mama taught me, that my environment taught me, that the school system taught me, the thing that got me believing that I don't have to listen to nobody else.
Yeah, so
the thing that got me believing, and for some of you want to listen, I'm sorry. We want to listen, but that thing's so stuck in us, we think you listen to me not. Because we hear what the preacher say, yeah, preacher, but we still go do what we always do. Because we're not really listening. We want to, but that old man is so strong, that natural man is so strong, that he won't allow us to receive the revelation. We shout about it, but he don't do it. So what we have to learn how to do is what Jesus did in the assembly. We got to die to our natural thoughts, our natural desires. Ah, God, I feel the Holy Ghost. And then it ain't easy.
No, it's not.
You got to make a choice. See, I made a choice today. And I'm telling you the truth, it ain't easy. But I thank God that I had experience with drugs because it taught me something that I could think it and feel it, but I don't have to do it. See, I made the decision back that I'm going to die to Lloyd Thompson's son. Not physically die, that natural man. The iniquity that came, once it's revealed, I become responsible. Someone say amen.
Amen.
So I made a decision in my life. I'm not going to continue in what my father did. I'm just not. And that ain't got nothing to do with being a womanizer, being lustful, you know, being wayward away from everything. No, that has to do with the little small things, being fearful, being timid, being non-confrontational unless you get angry. Anybody here? You put up all anything in the world, when you get angry.
Yeah.
That third person comes, someone say amen.
But see,
all of that. Not wanting to confront things, not being shame-based, afraid, don't want to confront things because you don't want nobody to tell you no.
Mm-hmm.
I know that's what I mean. I know you all got together. Keep me lifted up in prayer. See, that is the spirit, that is the iniquity that God helped me to preach to. That is the iniquity of my bloodline. So I don't like, I would rather not confront you before I have you tell me no.
Yes. Me too.
Somebody say amen. You know what? That's the spirit.
Yes. My God.
That's a shame, babe. That's an iniquity.
Wow.
Because you have boldness. He's giving you boldness and access with confidence. You have the right to come boldly before the throne of grace. So God gave me boldness as Christ. I'm bold. So I can't be responsible for how you respond.
Wow.
Yes.
But here's what that old man said. Oh, they can hurt your feelings. Now, my wife doesn't have that problem. She can confront anybody. That's not iniquity. It's okay. I tell her, you ain't got no shame. She's going to do something. But here's another thing. I'm going to get it off now. And by 8:30, we'll be finished up and give the children a little time because I'm already done. Here's what I'm doing. I want you all to take this with me, with you. What God wants to do, Pastor, is be believed. But in order for us to believe him, we got to die this old man. We got to recognize those things that we do that we're very comfortable with, that bring us pleasure sometimes, that they're not going to fit into the next place.
Wow.
Secondly, we have to recognize that there are some people who has we have their air. Amen? That we talk to them, that's what we focus on. When we get in trouble, we call them first. Y'all ain't talk to me.
Yes, sir.
You know, this is my sounding board, that's what we say. So that person, but as long as you're talking to them, you ain't talking to God. And for God to reveal things to you, you got to be in a still place, and most of the time in pain, in desperation. And if you're talking out all your desperation to somebody else, you can't receive the revelation. I'm not talking to you over there.
Yeah.
So now, there are two things I'm trying to give you. You got to believe. So I challenge every one of you all to go home, man, and look at where you're not believing God. Just look at it. Look at where it is that I'm not believing, Adam. Look at where I'm falling for the devil's lie.
Yeah.
Amen? Look at what I'm not believing. Look at that first. Where am I not believing? Because the only way I know I'm going to quench this work in my life is to not believe. And then I got to deal with this whole nature. I got to deal with these generational curses. Here's what I've been going on in my house. And I can see the result of it. I'm not going to lie about it. See, every time I pray now, I'm binding every iniquity from the generation of the Thompsons and the Evans on my side, and of the Smith and the Yerbys on her side.
Amen.
I know the same way too much work for some of y'all, but it depends on how bad you want it. Someone say amen.
Amen.
It don't take a whole lot to believe God. You have boldness to enter the Holy Spirit, blood of Jesus. You can go boldly into the throne of grace. See, I know that some things in our bloodline that I'm not going to be able to handle. Someone say amen. I know there's some things in my bloodline that she's not going to be able to handle. And the reason why we survived this far, because to be a showpiece concerning marriage and family, is because God kept us through His grace. But now that we've come to this place, that I know that I can stand in God's courts, having therefore brethren bolder than the holiest, that I can go right before God right now, just as I am, and I know that I can petition Him. Amen. Why? Jesus gave me access to go. First of all, you got to believe that. You believe you have access to God?
Yes.
So I know that I have the authority. I have power and clean spirits to cast them out of all manner of sickness and diseases. I got power to bind and loose. Y'all believe that?
Yes.
So I know now that I can make a decision every day and every time I pray to renounce the iniquity of my father, renounce the iniquity of my mother. Not that they were bad people. I'm not saying they're bad people. They just had what they had because it was handed to them as it was handed to me. So I can cancel that out back and let God know that I'm now under His blessing as His child. So I need to live according to the purpose of Jesus. But not only so, I got to go and be with her side of the family. I have to renounce the iniquity of the Smith family, renounce the iniquity of the Yerby family, and let God know that she's also His child. So now we are under a new kind of generation. We are under His blessing now. We're not under no curse or no iniquity. Are you following what I'm saying? See, it boils down to what I was saying in the beginning. Do you believe that enough to want to fight for your children, want to fight for your relationship? Do you believe that enough? Do you believe that this word is true? All God wants you to believe Him. Are we here? Do you believe that enough to go? See, sometimes poverty is generational. And you look at you because somebody in your bloodline decided, I'm okay with just enough.
Yeah.
And that spirit will pass down and pass down.
Yeah.
And God promised you millions and has given you opportunities and opportunities that have been shut down before you. I'm talking to myself because you don't understand that you're dealing with the Spirit.
My God. Come on, teach us.
Oh,
you're in the right place.
You don't understand. See, we have to learn how to understand. When you see it enough, you got to look at it and say, this thing has been handed down. You know, I can look at what my daddy did, how much my mother tried to push him, and it was just not in him to have wealth. Y'all ain't talk to me here. Y'all ain't talk to me here. And all of my brothers who are big time government officials and all that kind of stuff, who they're living comfortably, we all living comfortably, but they could have much more. But because we have this thing of pride, we're not going to step on nobody's toe to get to the next place. Y'all ain't talk to me here. How about the ocean?
This is where we are right now.
Is this where we're talking to here? Are you all hearing what I'm saying? You have to understand that the thing that got you stuck, and you keep having the same experience over and over, no matter how much you pray, it may be something you have to confront in your generational line.
Yeah,
wow.
And you have to be honest with yourself and say, this is who I naturally am. But now I have Christ in me too. So I can live on this side of it instead of this side of it. Someone say amen.
Amen.
So I can ask my Father, amen, because I'm asking every day, bind everything, and take every iniquity. I don't even use the word curse anymore because it's called, that's what they call a generation curse. But I can't be cursed because I'm in Christ.
Amen.
So I ask Him to remove every iniquity of the time. Listen, my wife, okay, my family's a great family. We get along great. I mean, we support one another. I mean, our family's like this. And I'm telling you the truth. But there are some things handed down that I'm not going to get into that I can see clearly that I don't want to be a part of. You know, I love them. I'm going to continue to love them. But I want all that I've been apprehended for.
Yes.
Good God.
Right.
Anybody that's been able to understand what I'm saying? So you have the authority to not allow the surname, that iniquity attached to the surname of your parents.
Mm-hmm.
Glory to God. That devil attached to the surname of your parent. You don't have to allow it to continue in your life.
Amen.
You can change it for you.
Mm-hmm.
And then change it for your children.
Yes.
Particularly those of you all, you know, I got a testimony today with someone in this ministry who believed in an impossible situation. And I said it before, and I spoke a word, I think it was Sunday, And these testimonies are coming up.